and welcome to Saurav's classes. In my previous video, I have already solved questions of Delhi School of Economics of the paper 2012 for the from 1 to 4. And now in this video, I am going to start with the question number 5. So the question number 5 says, Sania and Saina are bargaining over how to split ₹10. So it is a classic dollar splitting game. Both the claimants simultaneously name the shares they would like to have, which is S1 and S2, which is lying between 0 to 10. And S1 plus S2 is always adding up to less than equals to 10. And the claimants receive, if they claim something like this, then the claimants receives the share they names, otherwise they both receive 0. So find all the PO strategy Nash equilibriums. So in this game, if they claim like this, that is S1 plus S2 less than equal to 10, then they receive what they claims, or gets 0. Now here one may be tempted to say the Nash equilibria is 5-5. But hold on. Let us say that the player 1 chooses S1 and player 2 chooses S2, and S1 lies between 0 to 10 and S2 also lies between 0 to 10. So from the player 1's perspective, when the player 2 chooses S2, what is the best response for the player 1? It is B1 when the player 2 is choosing S2 equals to 10 minus S2. If he is choosing S2, then the best response for me to choose 10 minus S2. Again, for the player 1, if the player 1 is choosing S1, then from the player 2's perspective, the best response for the player 2 is to choose B2 S1, that is the best response function for the player 2 when the player 1 is choosing S1 is 10 minus S1. So the pure strategy Nash equilibriums are where these two best response functions intersects. Therefore, 5-5 is surely one potential Nash equilibria, but it is not the unique Nash equilibria. Any Nash equilibria or any combination pair such like 5-5, 2-8, 1-9, that adds up to 10 is the potential Nash equilibriums. Whereas if it is a pair like this, 5 plus 3, which is 8, which is clearly less than 10, then it cannot be a potential Nash equilibria, because then the player 2 has incentive to deviate. Therefore, the potential Nash equilibriums are all the Nash equilibriums for which S1 plus S2 equals to 10. So what is the correct option? The correct option then is the option number B. Now moving to question number 6, developing new antibiotics is expensive. It is known that more frequently bacteria are exposed to antibiotics, and the more frequently or more quickly the bacteria will develop resistance to the antibiotics. Yet usually each parents will praise a doctor for an antibiotic if there is a chance that it will heal a child quicker than without a drug. Which of the above statement is correct? The public good, that the bacteria is a public good, adverse selection, doctors. Doctors have information that is not available to the parents. Risk aversion, the parents are risk averse, and the short-run utility function, most parents are myopic and they fail to see the long-run effect. So starting with the first option, the bacteria as a public good means once they are produced or once they are produced means once the bacterias are exposed, once the bacterias are exposed, they create resistance, and then the antibiotic becomes obsolete. The second case is that the doctors have more information about than the parents. Obviously, the doctors have better understanding of medicine which is known as the adverse selection problem. The risk aversion, the parents are of course risk averse because they do care about their children, and the short-run utility maximization, more parents are myopic, that is they only see the short-run benefit, they only see the short-run benefit, not the long run. But though all these options are quite close, but the first best option will be that the public goods are that bacteria are public goods. So once they are exposed, the entire benefit of the medicines are gone. Therefore, the best option will be the public goods. So option A is the correct option. Moving to question number 7, if the correlation between the x and y is 0, then the regression line y on x and x on y intersect at right angle and pass through x bar y, but do not intersect at right angle, do pass through x bar y, but intersect at the right angles, but do not pass through x bar y, and do not intersect at the right angle and do not pass through x bar y. So the lines can be written like this: y minus y bar equals to b y x, x minus x bar, which is the correlation coefficient for y on x, and this is x minus x bar b x y, y minus y bar, which is regression line x on y. Now if the correlation coefficient is 0, then the correlation between the two variables is 0, then bxy equal is 0 and byx is also 0, then they do intersect at the right angles and pass through x bar y bar. So in this video I have covered from question number 5 to 7. I hope this is this will be helpful for you guys for exam, and until next time, thank you.